Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Welcome to my channel. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. In today's video, we're going to take a look at Outlook Desktop. This also exists on Outlook on the web. We're going to take a look at one group, but it is a very popular group for me. It is the Delete group. Let's dive in right now. So I have Outlook Desktop running. I could also be on Outlook on the web. And I happen to click on this message. It is from Microsoft. And I want to keep this message. Or this could be a message someone sent me, but there's nothing for me to do, but I just want to keep it. Right here is the delete group. It is on the home tab. And here's archive. In case you're wondering, if you have Microsoft 365, Outlook, Outlook 2021, Outlook 2019, or Outlook 2016, you have an archive folder already. This is not the same as the online archive that a lot of enterprise clients have. This is just part of your main inbox. So here I am again. I don't care about this message. Click on archive. There it is in my archive folder. It is not going to get deleted. It is in this archive folder. Nothing for me to do, but I wanted to keep it. Cool tip for you. Here's another one from Microsoft. If you don't want that, you can press the backspace key. That will archive something also. If by chance you press the delete key, that is going to send it to your deleted items. So I'm going to press backspace on the keyboard. Go to archive and prove. There it is. If you need to put it back in your inbox, just drag and drop it. Or you could right click and move it. There it is again. So that was archive. I use that a lot. Emails, I don't need to do anything with, but I want to keep. Now, if you don't want an email, I actually do want this email. If you don't want an email, just click on delete. Also, the delete key on the keyboard or Control D. Delete does work though. That will get rid of that email right there. Another cool tip is ignore. So I'm going to pick on this one right here. I usually use this for someone's birthday, and I know I sound horrible doing that, but it's Susan's birthday's coming up. This email went out to, I'm making this up, the entire company. There's 1,000 people, so a lot of people are going to be doing reply to all and keep saying happy birthday, Susan, something along those lines. If I delete it, I'm still going to get the reply to all from other people. So that is what ignore is for. I'm basically saying ignore this entire conversation in any, this email and any conversations after it with reply to all. So there is ignore. It's going to move it to deleted. Perfect. Hit ignore. But I'm not going to get any more reply to alls for that email that went out right there. Cleanup. I use this a lot. It's not as popular. I don't have to use it as much as I used to, but this is when an email goes out to multiple people. There's a lot of reply to alls, and when you start reading through them, you realize that some of the messages are duplicated. That is just what Outlook does sometimes. So that is exactly what cleanup is going to do. It's going to get rid of the redundant messages right there. I don't have an example of this. It's usually with a lot of people, a lot of reply to alls. It'll get rid of the duplicated messages. So it keeps the thread a lot cleaner. Junk email. I'm getting an email from somebody I don't care about. For that one right there. You can block the sender. Never block sender. Never block the sender's domain. Microsoft.com is a domain. Delta.com is a domain. The mailing list, in case you're wondering, why would I pick never block sender? If you come in here to your junk email options, you have a blocked senders tab in case you block somebody and didn't mean to block them. So there's that one right there. There are the five options you have in the delete group. You have these options also on Outlook on the web. Upcoming video that I'm going to cover is Microsoft Loop. You've got Microsoft Loop already in Microsoft Teams. You also have Loop in Outlook. This email from Carol that went to Christian and myself, Carol says we need to complete for the budget. we can all collaborate right here inside of this bulleted list. So there's no reason to do a reply to all and add on more bullets for me. And then Christian does a reply to all and add on more. We all just come right in here and start typing right inside this box right here. This even works with this being in an email message and in a Teams message. Someone could be in Teams updating this also. Really cool feature. I'll have a video on that soon. Feel free to ring the bell. Thumbs up this video if you like it. I appreciate your time. Have a great day.